Hey guys, as promised to you in the previous video that we are going to talk about exercises, and it's time that we clarify all the doubts that you have in mind. And like, this is a new series that we're going to talk about, and it will consist of different myths about exercises and how to do exercises and lots of stuff related to that. So with that, we'll start today's video. How are you feeling, guys? I hope you guys are feeling good, as am I, because this is a new series and there's a lot to talk about, and so much information is gonna share on this channel now. It's just unbelievable stuff. Today we are comparing two exercises. One is sit up and one is curl ups. And like, how we're gonna look at them is by looking at the biomechanical analysis of how a muscle works at the particular joint. So basically, the key reminder in this video, or whenever you do exercises, action is produced over a joint only when the muscle crosses it. If the muscle doesn't cross a joint, it won't produce that action. Simple example, your bicep crosses your elbow, that's why you're able to bend your elbow. If it doesn't cross your elbow, you won't be able to do that. With that in mind, we're gonna move forward now. So this is how a normal sit-up looks like. And you have to come all the way up and go all the way down. So let's break down the component of sit-ups in several motions. So first component will be, we initiate the movement, you can see the hip is flexing, and that is being done by your rectus abdominis, that is abs. We come up, and until here you're using your abs, and any motion further than this you'll be using your hip flexors, because the attachments of your abs is from ribs to your pubis symphysis area. The end part, this thing, you have to use your hip flexor in order to come up. And this is how normal curl up looks like. Come halfway and then go down. Come halfway and go down. Break the components for curl ups as well. So again, initial hip flexion, and then you come up half the way and you're using your abs to come up till there. There's nothing wrong about you do a sit up or a curl up. It's just, if you want to train your abs, you should do a curl up, because that is more efficient exercise for abs. And if you want to train your hip flexor, do a sit up. Why you need to know all of this is because a lot of people have anterior pelvic tilt. Most probably you will have a tight hip flexor. So, and if you're doing a sit up and you have already tight hip flexors, so you're training them more instead of stretching them. So it can cause even more anterior pelvic tilt. That being said, I hope I have cleared the doubts regarding these two exercises, and I'm gonna continue keep posting stuff like this related to exercise and other exercises forms as well. I hope you enjoyed this series, as well as my nutrition part and recovery areas of the fitness. Until next time, I'll see you in another video next week, either on Saturday or Sunday. Until then, see ya, goodbye, and have a good weekend. Oh wait, I forgot to tell you one thing. Please like and subscribe and share. It helps me a lot. See ya.